Hi, happy Mercedes -ing. In our today's video, we're going to be talking about the pressure loss. You've seen my previous video where I was showing you how it looks like to measure your pressures. So now I want to show you that we must make difference between two pressures. Not the system pressure and the control pressure, but there is the pressure when the engine is on as well as the one as the engine is off. Now, our topic for today is the pressure when the engine is off. So, as the engine is off, now we must maintain that pressure that is built in order for a car to start it easier. And now we have seven, and I repeat and show again, seven places to look at. Seven of them to check whether our pressure is falling or not. There are three crucial places, plus four, let's say, minor. Of course, the first place to look at is the fuel pressure regulator. What happens? As you stall the engine, the tight plate here moves backwards and it closes this passage. So no fuel can flow back to the fuel tank. That's place number one. Place number two is now the fuel pump. And not pump as pump itself, but its non-return valve. Because it's very easy to determine and to see if it's about a non-return valve, if it is the issue or not. You just have to stall the engine with your pressure gauge, of course, and if the needle drops the very moment back to zero, well, then you can clearly know it's about the non-return valve. But now, let's presume that we have a healthy non-return valve. The next place is going to be the fuel accumulator. The pressure of the engine is going to press, to compress its spring inside the diaphragm together with the spring. And it is going the spring is going to decompress bit by bit, bit by bit, bit by bit, until the engine achieves the operating temperature of under 60 degrees C. So then the cold start valve can help the engine start easier. But now, the fourth place to look for is the injectors. Why? Because as you stall the engine, the pressure falls at the very limit of the pressure that starts opening the injectors. For example, M102 engine, it's 3.2 bar. From 5.1 to 3.2. And if you have bad injectors, they start leaking, the used ones, at approximately 3.2 bar. So they're going then to drip fuel, and there you have fumes, there you have pressure loss. The place number 5 is going to be the cold start valve, because if it drips also, then pressure loss again. The place number 6 is the EHA, because as the fuel flows into the fuel distributor, it goes here, and it happens that the fuel starts leaking from this hole here of the EHA. And as soon as it starts leaking, then leaky EHA means pressure loss. And the 7th and the final place to look for the pressure loss is the plunger. If the plunger doesn't move as much as it has to, and if its seal ring is bad, if the plunger doesn't rest on its seal ring as it should, then the fuel is going to start dripping and there's the pressure loss again. So for all of you, now as I told you that I'm going to go back to that story about the injectors, some of you, for example, replace the fuel pressure regulator, this thing, they replace the fuel pump, they replace the fuel accumulator, the fuel filter, but they don't replace the injectors. So now, as this pressure of the engine stalled has to build, the pressure then is being maintained by the fuel pressure regulator. It is, for example, I'm speaking about M102 engines. It is approximately 3.2 bar. And that's exactly the limit as used injectors start opening and start spraying, as they do. Well, there is your issue. And one more thing. As for the fuel pressure regulator, there are still some of you that do not believe me that this is not the vent line. There are still some of you that think that there is some vacuum here. No vacuum here. Remember, no vacuum. And I'm going to demonstrate now. As we speak about vacuum, we are speaking about air, and I repeat, no air is here present, just fuel. Because here you have a diaphragm, here you have a spring, here you have a counter spring, and this part, this tube, is predicted just in case this diaphragm gets ruptured, that the fuel coming up from here, or from here, or going here, that it does not go, that it doesn't leak out from the regulator and leak out in the engine compartment, so that it stays here. This is just ventilation. In any literature you look, I have shown the diagram on my Instagram page, on my Facebook page here. I'm going to post the link here, and you can see that there is no vacuum here. If we start speaking about the EFI, then yes, there is vacuum there. But as for the KE, the pressure must be constant here and not variable, but constant. The system pressure cannot be changed. As much as you have it, that much is in your system, and it cannot be either raised or lowered. You cannot do that. And that's why there is no vacuum. So no vacuum here. This is just a ventilation line. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing.